There is another prerequisite that is required for evolution programming screencast, and that is random library. Random library is basically used to generate random numbers. I'll explain you some of the functions in random library. So first of all, start with rand int. So I'll just write random dot rand int 1, 2, 5. So as you can see, it has generated an integer from 1 to 5. Rand int is basically used to generate a random integer from 1 to 5. Please note the fact that 1 to 5, 1 and 5 are inclusive. It may generate 1, 2, 3, 4 or 5. Let us run it again and see the randomness involved here. Now it has generated 4. Again it has generated 2, again 4, 5. So as you can see that 5 is inclusive here, that's why it is generating 5. Again 5, 4, 1. So basically it has generated every number except 3. So let us run it again. Now it has generated 3 also. So random.randint is basically used to generate a random integer in the given range in which both the ints are inclusive. I'll use another function here, random.range. Please specify the range here. I'll again specify 1 to 5. So let us look at the output of random.range. random.randrange. Let us do that. It is 4, 1, 3, 1, 2, 2, 4, 3. As you can see that it hasn't generated 5. So rand range basically generates number from 1 to upper limit minus 1. It will generate number, it will either generate 1, 2, 3 or 4. So it won't generate 5 because it generates number from lower limit to upper limit minus 1. This is how randrange works. There is another function named random.random. Okay. It will generate number from 0 to 1. It will basically generate decimal numbers from 0 to 1. So let us run it. As you can see that it has generated 0.45. So if we run it again, it has generated 0.40, 0.83, 0.53, 0.62, 0.47, 0.92, 0.62, 0.73, 0.88, 0.83, 0.52, 0.054. As you can see that every decimal number that has been generated here is from 0 to 1. So random.random is basically used to generate random decimal numbers from 0 to 1. There's another thing involved in random.randrange. Let us explore that. And that is, for example, I want to generate numbers from 1 to 9, so I'll write here 1, 10, and I want to take a step of 2. I only want to generate, for example, odd numbers here, so I'll write 2 here. It will either generate 1, 3, 5, 7 or 9. Let us look at this. For example, it has generated 9. Let us check whether it generates only odd numbers or not. 1, 3, 1, 3, again odd number, odd number, odd number, odd number again, odd number, odd number, odd number. As you can see, it is only generating odd numbers. So how you can make random.randrange work like that? You just need to specify the range or you also need to specify the step that random.randomReach has to take. For example, here I specified 2, because if it will generate 1, then with the step of 2, it can only generate random odd numbers. So if you want to generate random even numbers, let us do that too. For that, I have to start with 2. Then it will generate only even numbers, and I'll generate till 11, because 10 is also even number. So let us run it. So it has generated 8, 10, even number, even, 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 even. So as you can see that it is only generating even numbers. That's how you can make random.randage to generate even and odd numbers and many other numbers of your choice. So this is how it works. There are many functions involved in random library. You can always Google it and explore many other functions. So I'll just give you a brief of that. So here we have many functions involved. We have random.choices. We have random.setState, getState, randRange, choice, shuffle, sample, random.uniform, random.triangular, random.betaVariate. I'll suggest you to go through all these random library functions. They are pretty interesting. I'll give you a demonstration of another function, that is random.choice. Let us do that. Random.choice basically generates random numbers from a given list. So I'll specify the list here. For example, I specify 1, 2, 3, 4. So it can only generate numbers from this particular list that I have specified here. So it has generated 3, 1, 4, 2. So as you can see, it can only generate number from the particular list. You can also specify the list. For example, I'll specify the list as my list is equal to any number you can specify, 11, 45, 67, 89. Okay. So random.choice you have to generate from my list. So let us try executing it. So it has generated 89. Since we gave only 4 numbers, 11, 45, 67, 89, it has generated 89. Run it again, it has generated 11, 11 again, 45, 45, 89, 89, 45. As you can see that it is only generating number from the list that we specified. We have specified the list as 11, 45, 67, 89, and it is only generating numbers from that. So I encourage you to explore more and more about random libraries. It has many other interesting functions too.